Welcome back to Sun Innovative YouTube channel, and we are back with a new video on 5 level direct clamp multi-level inverter fed induction motor drive. So in this video we are going to explain you the working of direct clamp multi-level inverter, and also we are going to generate the DC power to the AC, and we will feed to the induction motor drive. So in this video we are going to mainly focus on the 5 level direct clamp multi-level working and the output voltage of 5 level PWM technique by using the APOD PWM technique. So here you can see the explanation of circuit diagram. Here the four capacitors are connected, and here you can see the MOSFETs or IGBT switches are there. So first leg, it is having the 8 switches. You can see S1 to S4, that is a upper switches, and S1 dash to S4 dash, that is a lower switches. So it is also known as a first leg, and you can see the diodes are connected between these MOSFETs are there. So this is the topology of 5 level direct clamp multi-level inverter, and this is the first leg only. If you are working for the 3-phase, so you will be also required the 2 more additional this type of leg for generating the 3-phase output voltage, right? So here you can see the tables are given for calculating the number of switches, diode and the capacitor. So if you are working for the 3 level, so it means that you will need the 12 switches as a MOSFET or the IGBT, and the 6 diodes are there, and there are the 2 DC capacitor is required. Now in this case, in this video we are going to work for the 5 level. So let me show you the 5 level here. So this is the 5 level, and you can see this is the 24 switches are required, right? So here you can see this is the 4 switches and the below part 4 switches. So it means only the 8 switches are there, but this is only the leg 1. So if you are multiplied by the 3 numbers, so it will be a 3-phase, so there will be equal to 24 switches, and you can see that clamping diodes are required 36. So here you can see the numbers are multiplied here. So for avoiding the complexity, because you see this one diode is there, and the 3 diodes are similarly you can have to connect here, because you can see this between this point to this point there are the 3 switches are connected. To withstand the voltage, we also need a 3 diodes to maintain the voltage capacity across the 3 switches. So that's why the avoid the circumstances like if I am connecting the 3 more diodes here, so it will be not visible at all, because the circuit become more complex. That's why the equation is written D1 multiplied by 3. So similarly you can find here D2 is multiplied by 2, and the similarly D3 is multiplied by 3. So in short, you have the numbers here. In a first leg, you can see here the 1 plus 3 equal to 4 plus 2 equal to 6, and 1 more plus 2 equal to 8, and this is a 9, 10, 11 and 13. So 12, sorry. So it means that the first leg having the 12 diodes, right? And if you are multiplied with the 12 diode with the 3 legs, so it will be equal to 36 number here. Okay, so don't get confused. Please repeat this video. I'm shortly repeating this answer here. See here, to withstand the voltage capacity of these 3 switches, you can consider this point. Follow my mouse cursor here. You can see these points, because anode of the D1 is connected here, and cathode of D1 dash is also connected here. So between these 2 points, must remember, and please follow my mouse cursor and see the S3, S4 and S1 dash 3 switches is there. Once they are going to operate at immediately, so that time this diode should also have capability to withstand the voltage across these 3, 4 and 1 dash switches. So that's why, to avoid some complexity in the circuit, that's why we have written equation here multiplied by 3. In practically, you have to connect here 3 diodes, or you can also use the one diode which have the equivalent voltage blocking capacity as the switches has. Okay, so now coming back to this table, DC capacitor here, so you can see the 4 DC capacitors are required. So here the 4 capacitors are there, and below part you can find the table of switching for the MOSFET and IGBT, whatever you can use. So up to 1 to 4 upper switches, and 1 dash to 4 dash, that is a lower switches. So for developing the 5 level 0 to 4E, you need to follow this switching table, right? So now I'm going to show you the simulation part in this video and also show you the PWM technique for developing the multiple inverter output voltage. So this is the simulation part of PWM technique and the 5 level direct clamp inverter, right? So here you can see, according to the theory, there are 3 legs are there. So first leg having the first upper 4 switches and 4 lower switches, and you can also see here the second leg 4 switches and below part 4 switches. The similarly, the equivalency of third leg, and this is the induction motor is connected at the output of each and every leg. And here the arrangement for measurement purpose, and this is the PWM block subsystems are given for the each leg 1, 2, and 3, and you can see the measurement probes are connected. I will show you the results also. And this is the DC supply which we have given to this inverter. So now I'm going to quickly show you that how we can calculate it, right? Because we have some theory here. So now for particular 5 level, there will be a 24 switches is required. So you can calculate this this way. The 4 plus 4, that is a 8, and 8 multiplied by 3 lag, it will be equal to 24 switches. Now moving to the second theory, that is a 36 diode clamps are required according to this equation, must remember, right? But I am using the single diode here, and you can follow this equation, D1 multiplied by 3, D3 multiplied by 3. So you can have this diode calculation by this way, the each leg having the 12 diodes. So 12 multiplied by 3 equal to 36 diodes are there. Now this is the measurement purpose, the block is connected, and this is the subsystem for PWM. So now you can see here, this is the alternative phase opposition disposition PWM technique. So guys, if you don't know about this PWM technique, you can follow my video. The link is given in a description of this video. You just click that video. In that video I have clearly show you that how to develop the alternative phase opposition disposition APOD PWM technique for the multi-level, right? So in the short introduction, I can say that there will be a multiple carrier PWM signals are there, and the sinusoidal, that is a reference signal, and when the magnitudes are comparing with this carrier signal, it will generate the PWM pulses for each and every system. Like this is the first carrier, second carrier, third, fourth, 5, and 6. So that will be depend upon the how many switches are connected on upper switches, and how many switches are connected with the lower switches. So in our case, there is a 4 switches are used. So we will have the 4 different carrier PWM techniques, right? So you can see here, the 4 different blocks are connected here for developing, and this is a sinusoidal, so it will be a reference value. So we cannot consider this is for the carrier, but there will be a 4 different carrier signals are there, because we have the 4 upper switches are connected in a first leg. So now, coming back to the introduction part of induction motor here, and similarly, this is the phase B PWM technique, and here you can see the phase C is also there. So now this is a DC supply, and you can pause this video and you can develop this topology, and this is a very simple, I think in a connection it is a complex, but it is a very simple to get the multi-level output voltage. Okay, so if you have any question, please write in a comment box, I will reply. And now I'm running this simulation, you can see here. So it is going to run right now, and I will show you the results. So now you will see here, the RPM is going to increase, and it is reached to the 1500, I think, the almost the rated RPM here. And after simulation, I'm going to show you the output voltage and current. So it is taking some time to get finished this simulation, and let me show you first of all the PWM. We are starting with the PWM. So before showing you the output voltage, I will show you the PWM technique for the phase A. So let me open this scope. So you can see here the 4 different carrier signals you can see in the window, right? So color wise, you can also identify the 4 different carrier signals are there for the 4 switches, upper switches. And when I'm going to zoom this signals, you can see the reference sinusoidal signals is also there. and it is all about the comparison of four different carrier signals, right? And you can see the different patterns are there. And if you follow this pattern, it is nothing else, it is a alternative phase opposition and disposition technique, right? So you can follow my video of multi carrier PWM technique and you will be have the knowledge about how to generate this type of carrier signal, right? Now going back to the phase B here, so same way the four carriers are there and it will be also generate the same gate pulse as a phase A, but there is a little change here because this reference signal will be a 120 degree shifted, and the position of reference signal will be starting after the 120 degree because we are working on a leg B, so that's why it will be a shifted pulse. Now I am going to show you the output voltage and current here. So this is the output voltage and current you can see here, and you can follow the color line, black and dark brown is there, and dark yellow is also there, and this is the current. And now I'm opening the each phase voltage here. You can see this is the output voltage of A, B, C phase, and let me zoom the part of phase A so you can also understand how PWM is going to work here. So let me zooming this part so you can see easily here right now. So this is nothing else, this is a PWM signals are there. And by using the APOD technique, you can also generate this type of phi level. So let me calculate the phi level. So this is the first, second, third is a zero, fourth and fifth level. So it is a phi level inverter output voltage for the each phase. And let me open the final result for this one. So you can see this is the DC voltage which we have given here. And this is a multi-level inverter output voltage, you can see this one. And this is the motor speed last third block, you can see this is the graph is speed, this is a rated output speed. And let me zoom this output voltage so you can easily understand. This is the output voltage, this is the input DC voltage, and this is the motor speed. So that's why you can see the DC voltage is now converted to the AC, and that AC voltage is given to the induction motor, so we are getting this motor speed like this way, okay? And this is the performance parameters of DC motor. This is the electromagnetic torque developed by motor, and this is the induction motor speed in RPM. It is working on a rated speed, you can see here the magnitude is there. So now this way you can generate the gate pulse for this type of three phase five level induction motor fed, a multi-level inverter fed, induction motor drive. And this is all about how to convert the and how we can use the multi-level. So in the most advantage part is that you can reduce the switching loss by having the voltage level by reducing the capacitors. And also there is a disadvantage also there, the imbalance phase voltage, and it is a complex to control in a PWM site. So this is all about the multi-level, five-level inverter fed induction motor drive. So thank you guys, thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you.